Hey there, I'm Brendan Peterson, the founder of Darkslide Pictures and the director of Paper Wasps. Welcome back to Appalling Productions Mondays. It's been a while since the last episode. It took quite a while longer to make this than planned. We had planned to have it every Monday, but it seems that we're not going to be able to quite do that. But hopefully every second or third Monday we'll be able to have an episode consistently. So welcome to 7 no-budget, do-it-yourself filmmaking tips. In this episode, I'll be going over 7 different tips that are kind of like anecdotal tips that I've found that helped me along the way in making my no-budget films, and also on how to make them stand out a little bit from other no-budget films being created, and in that way maybe get into some festivals and start garnering some attention for yourself as an artist. Okay, well let's get started with tip number one. Tip number one is know about the camera. Not every director is a camera wizard. Kevin Smith has fully admitted that he doesn't know a whole lot about cameras, but he still makes great films. However, cameras are getting more affordable and easier to use at a fast pace. Learn about what makes a camera worth using. Dynamic range, codec, resolution, aspect ratio, the lens mount, sensor size. These are all factors that weigh into how well a camera will perform. The camera we have chosen here at Darkslide Pictures is the Blackmagic Cinema Camera 2.5K version with EF mount. I find that the look we have is about equivalent of digital Super 16 film around there, and we're able to shoot with the Apple ProRes codec, which pretty much doubles the color depth from what's called H.264, which is the common codec of DSLRs. So just know about the camera. Tip number two is pick up graphic design. Photoshop is an insanely powerful tool that can take a stale image and within seconds make it stand out to the eye. Graphic design allows you to have consistency when promoting your film, with thumbnails for trailers and videos, posters, banners, cover photos, profile pictures. They'll all adhere to one style with a proper size for each format. People are being bombarded with content, and I find that it helps to be as clear and concise as possible with the message. That doesn't mean you can't be mysterious, but it means you should always remember that every image shown to the public represents your work. Tip number three is study the sound. I find that the best people to ask advice about sound are sound engineers themselves. Filmmakers can be very knowledgeable, but the engineers specialize in sound. Sometimes they know little tips and tricks or how exactly to approach different recording scenarios in different ways than a filmmaker might normally suggest. Learn about different kinds of microphones such as shotgun mics, cardioids, omnidirectionals, lavaliers, and condensers, finding out the advantages and disadvantages of each. As well, consider recording your own music for your project or approaching other music creators and ask them permission to use their music. This will give you a chance to bring an original tone and atmosphere to your film. Number four is find your unique advantage. By unique advantage, I mean things that you already have in your life that are unique to you, whether it's people you know who can act or have a talent, locations that you can get due to family or friends, networking advantages if you know people with experience, etc. Everyone has some sort of unique advantage. They say you should write what you know, and I believe that's true, but you should also not be afraid to write what you don't know. With this said, I feel that one thing to remember is that it's helpful to write about things you're already interested in and knowledgeable about. If you know a ton about mechanics, maybe you should write about a mechanic. If you play sports religiously, perhaps a movie about a person who shares similar interests. You likely have a bunch of stuff already kicking around in your life that could act as props or just objects that will help kickstart a story. Number five is to do things on set in a timely fashion. At a no-budget level, you're likely not going to be able to pay your cast and crew much, if anything at all, which means they'll be volunteering their time. And when people are volunteering their time, I rarely push them to do things like 12-hour straight shoots, and if you do, it's important to probably provide food for them, at least. And I want to make sure people are having fun, especially if they're not getting paid. Many shooting days on Dark Slide, our first feature film, would only be about 4 to 6 hours long, and we just had many shooting days over about a year or so. And it's not the usual way to shoot a movie, but sometimes you have to work around other people's schedules because they have lives and a job, and I'm not able to take them away from that and pay them, so you have to really cater to your volunteers' time. Number 6 is consider crowdfunding, but with caution. Everyone wants to make movies with someone else's money, and the key to doing this seems to be appealing to their sentiments. The crowdfunding projects that I often see get funding successfully convince the argument that their project offers something unique or something that no one else has ever talked about, or that the idea itself is in fact important to be talked about in the first place. With flexible funding, even if you don't reach your overall goal, you still have a chance to generate funds towards making the film happen. And when you're starting with nothing, at a no-budget level, it can only really go up from there. So that's how I see crowdfunding as a success, as long as it's getting closer to your goals. Remember that as the creator, it's up to you to finish the project despite adversity. Number 7 is the sky is the limit. Like the Robert Rodriguez school of filmmaking, you should start writing in what you already have, and that will give you a good baseline. But from there, I say the sky is the limit. Don't limit your imagination, I mean within reason. If you want a helicopter chase, do it, but conceit that you might have to use miniatures or sound trickery or something, but it's not going to look exactly like a James Bond film that you see in Silver City. Remember, the story is number 1, so don't be afraid to tell your story any way you can. Focus on strengthening the world in which your story takes place. So you can dream big. If you want your character to turn into a giant, the sky to turn purple, and an evil vortex to appear protruding the horrifying tentacles of the old ones, like, I say, just do it. You can figure out a way with creativity that doesn't need thousands of dollars, and what you imagine can be more grand than what is capable in reality, but this should not be limiting. Focus on capturing the feelings and the message of what you imagine with the means and the materials that you have in real life. Okay, thanks for watching 7 no-budget DIY filmmaking tips, and I hope this helped you in some way, or maybe inspired you a bit in creating your own no-budget films. Also, I want to mention right now, we're aiming to elevate our projects with each one we've created, and so our next project, Ha Ha Jackal, requires a bit more budget than our previous projects. Like I've said in this video, we created them for $4,000, what, the first one around there, and $1,000 the second one. And currently, right now, we're running an Indiegogo campaign, which I'll link to below, for Ha Ha Jackal, which is the next project, which is a bit bigger in scale, and we'd like you to check out the video explaining a bit of the plot and a taste of the atmosphere of the film. It's the Indiegogo campaign video for Ha Ha Jackal. So, yeah, check it out. See y'all later.